Hi, I'm Heather, one of the systems engineers here at Pessler. After a few of my other videos, I got some feedback that I didn't really explain what the Sunburst is enough. So I decided to make you a Sunburst video. The Sunburst displays your device tree in a circle diagram, so come on, let's go take a look and I'll walk you through it a little more. All right, so to get into the Sunburst view from your device tree, you come to the top here. And for the switch the tree view icons here, you want to do the circular one. And that will bring up your Sunburst. Once it comes up, and I'm doing it from the root, so we're going to see the whole entire device tree in the Sunburst. So let me explain to you what's going on here, because I know there's sometimes confusion about that. It starts from the inside out, and on the inside here are your probes. So I have three probes, so I could see one probe here, one probe here, and then this is my third probe, which doesn't have a lot of devices on it. Now, if there is an alert into the branches, then that's going to start on the inside. So because something under this probe here and this probe here is in an alert or the red status, that's why the inside is in red. And then this one has something in warning, so that's why that little slice is yellow. After the probes are various groups here, and they're divided into, we'll say, cake slices in this round circular view. And you go through your whole group structure. Now, because there are groups and nested groups, and every device is different, some devices have a lot of groups, some have less, and that's why this is jagged and some have more layers than others. It's never going to be a perfect circular pattern here, just because that's how your device tree typically is. And then at the very end, your devices are represented once you get through the groups. So it's a clickable part of the device tree, just like your normal device tree if you're in the small, medium, or large view. And if I just go to any part here and click, it's going to take me to that part of the device tree in a Sunburst in itself. Now this one, unfortunately, I clicked a bad one because there's one thing there, so that was not the best example I could have clicked on. You don't know because those icons are smaller, so let's try a different one where you'll see a little bit more into it. I'm going to try here, for example, in my cloud services. So not as much, it's not as busy as from the root view, but this is still a Sunburst view, and I'm seeing my different groups and devices here. So now let's go here to the Office 365 cloud. That's my devices. It's at the end of the Sunburst, and then I see my sensor here. So if I go back to devices in my device tree, because the view I had selected was the Sunburst, that's going to come up again. So until you switch the device tree back to small, medium, or large, it will stay at the Sunburst view at this point. So typically, I don't see many customers keep the Sunburst view, but some do prefer to do it. So here I pulled up the group network, and you're going to see the Sunburst is a little busier than the other Sunbursts. And again, inside out, the various groups to more groups to the devices. And then if I click here, I'm going to see my device VPN traffic and then see my sensor list is here. So let's hit the home button again and go back to devices. And you see my Sunburst. So when I do want to get out of this view, I can click my icon here for the medium view, which is typically my favorite view because I like how that looks. The other place you can use the Sunburst are in your maps. Click on maps here, and I'm going to take a look at two of my favorite maps. First, we're going to just go to this dashboard from 2018, and you're going to see some examples here of how you can use the Sunburst. Here, I just have my three probes represented, just Sunburst of the probes. So when you are building a general dashboard, that's a great way to do it. I don't want you to confuse the term Sunburst with donuts, because donuts came out in PRTG about a year or so ago. And this here is an example of a donut. Donuts are one circular view where the Sunburst has the jagged view, and it's just taken whatever we're looking at in the donut, and here's just the sensor alert states, and you could see because there is 3,839 sensors in green status, you could see more green here, and then of course, you know, a few in alert, a few in warning, and that's why these slices of the donuts are represented. So if you do hear about the donut view, that's what that is. And there's sensor views here in Sunburst, and I'm going to show you one more map that has an example. If I go to my OneView map, and I can see here I have the probe represented here, but then here is one group represented in the Sunburst, so you can do various different Sunbursts in your map. So that is our video on Sunburst. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us at support@pessler.com, and please take a look on our website to look at other videos about PRTG. If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pessler.com, and always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.